Hi guys, today I'll be showing you how to restore files on an Autel device just in case your files get corrupt or you want to restore your device to an earlier time. I had done an earlier video on how to back up your Autel device but didn't cover how to do a restoration. This procedure will work on any Autel tablet style scanner and not just the MP808TS. Now let's get this. Restoring your files implies that you have a backup to restore from, and by files I mean vehicle updates, scan reports, and all. Just as I said in the backup video, if you don't have a backup and you're out of subscription, should your files get corrupt or you do a factory reset, the only way to get your files back will be to buy an Autel subscription. I can't tell you the number of people who have reached out to me with this particular problem, which could have easily been solved if only they had a backup. This is just a nudge to you if you're watching this video and you haven't made a backup, be sure to do so as soon as possible. The link to the video on how to back up your device is on the screen. To restore your files, you just need to click on this home button and select ES File Explorer. On the left hand pane, you can see that there's an internal SD tab. Click on that and then scroll down and locate the scan folder. The scan folder is the heart and soul of data on any Autel device and it contains vehicle updates, service function updates, history of scan reports, and so on and so forth. Before starting the restoration process, the first thing to do is to close the MaxiPRO or MaxiCOM or MaxiSYS app and then insert the SD card that has the backup data into the SD card slot. You will now see that you have an external SD, that's the SD card that we just put in. At this point, we go back into the internal SD, select the all important scan folder and delete it. The reason you want to delete and not overwrite this folder is that depending on the size of the storage on your device, you may not have enough space to run an overwrite process. It will take some minutes to estimate the size of the folder and once it's done, you can see that the folder size is 21 GB plus. We go on to confirm delete and while that's running and because of how long the entire process is going to take, it's a good idea to plug in the charger. The folder deletes and just for demonstration purposes, I exit the File Explorer and click on the MaxiPRO app. At this point, it takes a longer than usual time to open because it's trying to re-establish a rudimentary scan folder. When it finally opens, I go into Diagnosis and click on History, and as you can see, all previous scan reports have been deleted. I exit from there and you can see that we now have a total of 175 pending updates. This is as against the 110 that we had before we started this process. Now let's restore the files. Go back into the File Explorer, select the internal SD. Here you can see the rudimentary scan folder that has been created. I select it and choose delete. It's just a paltry 52 MB. That deletes. I go to the external SD, press and hold the scan folder and that selects. I click on copy and then come back to the internal SD card and click paste. It takes a while to get an estimation of the file size, but it finally ends up as 21 GB. And again, this process takes a long time. In real time, this took about 1 hour 30 minutes. And finally, it completes. I relaunch the MaxiPRO app and go into Diagnostics. And as you can see, all my previous scan reports are now back. I exit from there and you can also see that the pending updates have now dropped from 175 to 113, showing that some vehicle updates have been restored and the scanner is now exactly at the point where the backup was created. Hope this has been helpful. Catch you on the next one. Peace!